Hi beauties, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new,
hi hello.
It's Angel Flores, welcome, welcome, faux sure. So today we dove into our first holiday look. It's a little bit bold, it's a little bit more than like, you know, you typically do. I went all out, honey, listen. It's all or nothing, okay?
Okay.
Without further ado, let's dive right in. Per usual. You know, skin's already prepped, ready to go. So now we're gonna dive into the eyeballs. To prime my eyes, I'm gonna use the Too Faced Shadow Insurance 24 Hour Wear Creaseless Eyeshadow Primer. I like this one, cause you know, helps with the oil. It really does help for it to stay on all day. Pea size amount. Just dab it in. Today, we're going to be going in with the Morphe X Jaclyn Hill Collaboration Palette. So it's this big one right here. As you can see, it is ginormous. But yeah, this is what the palette looks like. It is beautiful. We're going to be diving into this range right here for our look. First, I'm going to grab just a flat, fluffy eyeshadow brush, and I'm going to use translucent setting powder to lock my primer in place. I'm gonna go back in with the Jaclyn Hill palette, and as our transition shade, we're going to be using this color right here. Start in the center, go back and forth. That'll place the product exactly where we want the product to be, and then we'll do little circles to buff it out so it blends out the edges. We don't want to form rainbows, we don't want to form horseshoes. We want it to diffuse and fade out. We're going to be going very dark, very smoky, so I am going to be building up this transition shade just a little bit more than normal. So I'm going to go back into it one more time. Windshield wipers, little circles, windshield wipers. I'm going to go in with my Morphe M576. This is a little bit more tapered, as you can see right here, and we're gonna dive into the color, this color right here, and we're just gonna kind of put it right where that crease is and on the lid, just all over the lid. Again, we're building up into a smoky gradient effect all over the lid, so right in the eye socket, right in there, right in here. You're gonna pat, pat, pat. This is the only area you don't wanna do the windshield wiper little circus motion. You just wanna pat, pat, pat. You really want that eyeshadow primer to grab the powder, lock it in so it does not move, does not crease. Okay, now I'm gonna tap all the excess off on my brush as much as I can. I even wipe it a little just to get any residue and anything that might still be there. And we're gonna hover right in between those two shades. Very gentle. You want to do circular motions. Be intentional about your blending. Don't just go crazy, because then you can make it look muddy. Okay, so now we're gonna go back into the brush we first used. That was the Morphe R40 right here. We're gonna dab into that same transition shade, just a little tap. Tap the excess off. Then we're just going to hover back and forth motions over the blend of the two again, so you get that color back layered on top of what you just blended out. Because again, you want that grading. You put those colors there for a reason, so you want them to show. So we're going to go dive into our deepest shade we're going to be using today. Actually, not quite, because we are going to use a little bit of black. So we're going to go into this dark emerald. It's like a deep forest green. It's really pretty. We're just gonna put that all over the lid. Again, you wanna be very intentional, so take your time with this. Start in the center and then work your way out. I'm using a flat Sephora shadow brush. This is number 15. And pat, pat, pat. Kind of like that. Now I'm going to build it up just a little bit. So I'm going to go back into the pan.
If it's starting to look like you have a black eye, then you're doing it correct.
Now I'm going to go into my Makeup Forever Professionals Flash Color Palette. This has 12 different colors. This is what I used to do Halloween looks. They're just basically cream colored products for face and body. I'm going to dive into the yellow one, and I'm going to be using the yellow one to create a wing.
I'm an idiot. That's not what I was going to use. I bought it.
Okay, so now, going in with the right product, it's the NYX Vivid Brights Liquid Eyeliner. This is in the shade Vivid Halo. It's just the yellow one. Shake it on. And let's do these wings. Alright, so now I'm going to go in with a synthetic brush. This is the Morphe M207, just an angled brush. And what we're going to do is we're going to dive into the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna in the shade Trophy Wife. And we're going to actually put this right on top of the yellow. Alright, so now that the top part is pretty much done, actually before I move on to the complexion, I'm going to tightline the top part just to give it more depth and more fullness to my lashes. Using the Smashbox Gel Eyeliner. So this is a gel formula in a pencil form, and it's a sharpened one, which is nice. I really like this one. 24-hour wear, smudge-proof, waterproof. It will not budge or rub anywhere unless you physically are rubbing and scrubbing, but then that's everything. It's makeup. If you rub it, it's going to come off. My other favorite one is Marc Jacobs.
That one's my go-to, but, you know.
This is at my reach. So, when I say tight line, that one is the top part up here of the eyelid. So not the bottom one where the regular waterline is. You want to do it at the top. So the top part of the eyes is turning out very, very well. I'm so happy with the outcome. This is bold again. Bolder than initially planned, but
I'm not mad at it. It's you know, my artistic stuff, you know?
It's like it's getting my, you know what? Now looking this close, the only thing I don't like is this NYX Vivid Brights. It's very dry. Alright, so we're going to move on to the face. I am going to film it. I'm going to let you guys see how I do. We're just going to run through this a little bit quicker. Okay, so we're gonna dive back into our Jaclyn Hill palette. I'm gonna go in with my Morphe M62 brush. It's that small precision one that I had mentioned in my previous video. Diving into the color we used in our transition shade first. So this tone right here. Then we're gonna put that all along the bottom on our lash line. You wanna start in the center, work your way out. And then start feathering it in slowly. Okay, so now we're gonna dive into that second shade we used, which was that turquoise. This one here, we're just gonna do one, two, and we're gonna blend that in as well, right in there. Trying to focus in that closer to the actual lash root. Okay, now going in with my smudge brush, I'm gonna dig into that darker green, so the darkest one in the palette right here yet again, and we're gonna focus that as close as you can to the lash line. So that outer half is where you wanna put it. All right, so now we're going to set the rest of our face. So I'm gonna set with my usual combo. So the Laura Mercier Sheer Perfecting Candle Glow Powder. This is in the shade number 2, and that is what it looks like right here. I'm gonna be mixing that one with the Maybelline Superstay Better Skin Perfecting Powder. This is in the shade 25, the warm beige, so it looks like here. So like we did last time, we're just gonna grab both of these. I'm gonna do a little mixture of both with my Morphe MB1 brush and just press. All right, we're gonna go ahead and finish the rest of the face. You know, add a little dimension, a little contortion, and a little
bling bling blinding highlight.
And yeah, then we'll be back to finish the eyes.
Porque sé que volverás. Si conmigo te quedas o con otro tú te vas, no me importa un carajo porque sé que volverás. Y si con otro pasas el rato, vamos a ser feliz, feliz en los cuatro.
Alright, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and put some of this black eyeliner. This is the same one I used on top. We're just gonna put it on the bottom in the waterline to deepen up the look. So let's hurry up and finish these eyeballs. We're gonna put a little mascara, you know, just for some support. I always like to put a little bit on so the lash has something to sit on. For mascara, I'm gonna go in with the Monsieur Big by Lancome. I love this one. It's gonna give a lift, curl, and volume. It's really nice. It actually does lift my lashes, which is nice because not all of them do. I've only been able to find two that do that, and that's the Roller Lash and this one right now. Yeah, but before I do that, we're gonna curl these lashes up to Jesus! And for my bottom lashes, I'm gonna go in with the Maybelline's The Colossal Volume Express, the Hydro Focus one. It grasps my bottom lashes really nicely. It's curved. It has the right amount of bristles in there to really separate them. And mine are really itty bitty and straight, so this really gets in there and I'm able to elongate them. Okay guys, so for the lashes, we're gonna go in with these Huda Beauty lashes. They're gonna be the Jade's number 13.
And voila.
The lashes just really bring out the look. It makes it stand out, just pulls it all together. Of course, I still need brows. I feel bald and a lip, but we'll get to that. So, I did not like how these Vivid Brights by NYX are dry, and you can tell that they're dry. So I'm gonna be going in with the Urban Decay Heavy Metals Glitter liquid eyeliner right here. I just bought it. This is one of their newer shades in Pyro. So I'm gonna put this right on top of the Vivid Bright and Trophy White. To set my face, I'm going to be using the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Spray Setting Spray. This one is like a nice, it's a microfine, so it's very similar to the Kat Von D that I have here, but it's more affordable. And it just helps with the longevity of makeup. You wanna shake it, arms length. Because I'm not glowing enough, we're going to do the Tatcha Luminous Dewy Skin Mist. I love this! This gives like a nice dewy glow to the skin. But you do want to like be careful because you can look greasy. So I'm going to like block my face. Just do this side.
Woo! Just on the outsides. Alright!
Remember that lip liner from the last video? Yeah, we're using it again today. Okay?
Okay.
It is the Lancome Sheer Natural Le Lipstick Zoo. I don't know. I'm making a mess.
Okay, she coming together, honey.
Okay, and for my lipstick, I'm gonna be using the Sephora Collection number 25 Coral Sunset.
Ah! Yes! Girl!
Alright, I'm gonna go put some earrings, I'm gonna change and do my final cut of this thing, and let's wrap it up. Take my pictures before my eye falls apart. Ew! So that completes the look, guys. Hope you love it. Look at this, giving you top turt knot classic chic bun with this terracotta corally red lip. Definitely smoky, definitely asking for attention, definitely being like,
listen, holiday party, what? Look at me.
So yeah, hope you guys like it. If you have any other requests for holiday or in general, if you want to learn anything, you want me to break anything down, skincare, everything, don't forget to leave it in the comments down below. And like always, give me a thumbs up if you liked it and enjoyed this video. And like, share, comment, subscribe to my channel. Bye guys, love ya.
What am I gonna do? Take it off and do it again? I don't wanna do that.
Twitching. I feel it.